I hated this part of my job. Have you ever had a job that you really liked, but there were certain parts of the job that you just hated? You hated whenever you had to do it. It was just that one thing that you really disliked about being in that job. Well, for me, as an infection preventionist, the one thing that I really hated about my job was answering questions. And if you are an IP, you know that we have to answer questions all the time. We get asked questions from the minute we start at work to the minute we leave. It is just question after question, or that's how I feel like a lot of times is that I get asked questions all the time. Just when I'm out doing rounds and then on email, I'm getting asked questions. So I feel like it's something that I'm doing all the time. So it did not work well that was the one thing that I hated doing was answering questions because that was the majority of my job at the beginning. So I wanted to talk about it today because I feel like some of you may be having that same difficulty of not wanting to answer questions or just dreading it whenever people ask you questions. And so I thought it might be helpful for me to share with you some things that I found out about myself, why I hated being asked the questions, and how you can flip that around so that you can embrace the questions. Because I can tell you now, 20 years into infection prevention, I don't hate being asked questions anymore. I actually like it when people ask me questions because I like to engage with people. I like to be able to answer questions and help them with infection prevention. So the first thing that I'll say about if you are struggling with answering questions or if you hate it may be because you don't have confidence in yourself or confidence in the answers that you are going to give. And that was me. When I first started out, I didn't have the confidence that I needed to give the answers to the questions. I felt like I didn't know the correct answer. I was unsure of the answer. And of course, I didn't want to say, I don't know the answer to that question, but let me get back to you. So how I approach that is, number one, when I would get the answers to questions, because you'll find the same questions will reemerge over time. There's some questions that I've answered thousands of times. So one thing that I've done is I've written down the answers to those questions. And so that I have that available and I know, I've answered this question before. This is the answer to the question. So that kind of decreases that level of anxiety because I've already answered that question before. I know the answer. I've done the research. And that's the other piece too, is do the research. And if you don't know the answer to the question and you need to do more research, it's okay to say that. That doesn't make you look unintelligent or make you look bad to say, you know what, that's a great question. I need to go research that and I'm going to get back to you with the answer. And guess what? After you go research it, most of the time you're going to remember the answer to the question. And the person, a lot of times, they're not going to be upset that you didn't know the answer to the question right then. They're going to be upset if you never give them the answer to the question. But if you come back and give them the answer to the question, then you've solved their problem. And so it's okay to do that. And I find many people when they're first starting out, they're afraid to say, I don't know the answer to the question. But guess what? If you're new to IP, you're not going to know all the answers to the questions. No one knows all the answers to the questions. So just be okay with that to say, you know what? I don't know the answer to the question, but I'm going to get that answer for you. And then you can be confident in the answer that you give them. The second thing is if you really need more education, like if there is a topic that you feel like you don't know enough about, then educate yourself. And I can tell you, when I first started out in IP, I hated getting questions about sterilization in the operating room. And the reason why is because number one, I never worked in the operating room. I had never been a person who sterilized instruments. So it wasn't something that was intuitive to me or that I, didn't have to go do some research on or look at. So what I did is I educated myself more on that topic. I knew that was a weakness of mine. And so I educated myself more on the topic. And I always had cheat sheets for that particular topic because If you have looked into disinfection and sterilization, particularly in the OR, you know there's a lot of different ranges and different numbers to remember and different types of tests to remember. And so it's good to have a cheat sheet handy. If you don't talk about it all the time, you forget those types of things, especially if it's not something you do all the time. So learn more about the topic. If there's something that you're truly uncomfortable about because you know that there's a knowledge gap there, then fill that gap and learn what you need to know about that topic. The final thing I want to talk about in terms of answering questions is, you know, what I find is the third reason why people don't want to answer questions, and the reason why I didn't want to answer questions is I was afraid to answer the questions. Why was I afraid? I was afraid I was going to be wrong. And so, you know, that really caused a lot of anxiety as well, thinking, you know, what if I give them this advice, or what if I answer this question and I'm wrong and it's not the right answer? And guess what? We're all human. You're going to give a wrong answer. I have given wrong answers before. But again, like I said before, go back and make it right. If you give the wrong answer and you think about it and you realize, you know, that wasn't the right answer, go back and tell the person, hey, you know, I told you wrong earlier this morning. This is actually the right answer. Don't be so hard on yourself. You're not going to know everything. Even though I've done this for almost 20 years, I don't know everything. There are still questions that I don't know the answer to the question. And I have to give those responses, like what I said earlier, I've got to do more research. Now, I don't have as much of a fear of being wrong anymore, not because I'm never wrong, but because I know that if there's something that I'm wrong about, I'd have made that discipline to go back and follow up with that person and say, hey, I was wrong, and this is the right answer to the question. So these are just a couple of things that I've learned over the years that have helped me. And if you are struggling and just having that anxiety or fear about answering questions, think about these. Think if they apply to you. Maybe it's a whole different thing that's keeping you from not wanting to answer questions. But if you're an infection preventionist, it's part of your job. And spoiler alert here, you're going to continue to get the same questions asked. You're going to always have people asking you questions. That's just part of it. And since you are working towards being the expert, that's what you want. You want people to ask you questions because you are the expert. You are the one who is pursuing more knowledge and more expertise in infection prevention. So leave me some comments below, definitely if this resonates with you, or if you have something else that you hate about your job as an IP, let me know in the comments, or if you have battled some of these same things and how you overcame them, especially if you have some tips that worked for you that are different from mine. And I hope you have a great rest of your week. Stay safe, friends, and I'll see you soon.